Which of the following is an assumption that supports drawing the conclusion above from the reasons given for that conclusion? Kind of a mouthful of a question. But essentially, it's saying there's an assumption, and that assumption is important if the conclusion is going to be accurate. So, what is the assumption? Let's tease this out of here. It's the idea that there's been experimentation in art, and it's no longer about what's necessarily beautiful, but what's abstract or shocking. And then it goes on to say that artists have, as one of their goals, creation of work that no one can find beautiful. We are going to create something so horrific and shocking that no one will ever think it's beautiful. Then we have this important sentence. Whatever these artists are creating may be intellectually engaging at some level, but it is no longer art. Why? Because no one can find it beautiful. Therefore, for something to be considered art, it must be considered, at least by some, beautiful. We go back and we now try to home in on an answer that matches up with our logic. A, art critics generally have a different appraisal of work of art. Nope. The meaning of any work of art isn't defined entirely by the ideas of the artist. Nope. It's defined to an extent by beauty, if it is to be called a work of art, is what we're going for here. See, beauty is a defining quality of art. For something to be considered art, it has to be beautiful. That's what we're going for.